This is O Street in Georgetown, and as you can see, there are metal rails running along the pavement, like the tracks of some ancient animal that once lumbered along these cobblestone streets.
Huge lumbering creatures did once roam our city streets, leaving their unmistakable tracks in every corner of the city and filling the air with their squeals and rumbles. But these ancient creatures, which once flourished throughout the nation, finally met their natural enemy, the automobile. It was survival of the fittest, and the trolley lost. Today, the creature we call a trolley is extinct. Almost. There is a preserve where the trolleys still roam free, safe from the autos and buses which force them from the streets. It's the National Capital Trolley Museum, an assortment of about a dozen trolleys and 2 miles of track, scenically sequestered in the woodlands of Wheaton's Northwest Branch Regional Park. And in this impressive preserve, kids can take trips on trolleys that even their parents may not remember.
The car on which you're riding was originally a New York City streetcar. But it ran for 20 years in Vienna, Austria. Not Vienna, Virginia, but Vienna, Austria. The gentleman up front is the motorman. I am the conductor. And I have to give him bell signals so he will know when to go. If you'll listen now, you'll learn what that signal is for the car to go.
It's a Friday, and a volunteer motorman and conductor are taking youngsters on the weekly school trips. On weekends, the museum is open to the public from noon to five, and a trolley trip costs 75 cents for adults, 50 cents for children over two. That's the price for a quick trip back into time.
With someone like you,
children have a question. What's your question?
How fast does it go?
We don't run it as fast as it will go. If we had enough track and enough cars and didn't worry about it, it might go 45 miles an hour. We run it much more slowly because we have to take care of it.
And who are the folks that take care of this threatened species? Who tends the tracks that carry the trolleys that transport the people that ride the rails of the Trolley Museum? Who cleans the cars and takes the tickets and drives the trolleys?
Everything here which is a part of the museum, the cars, the track, the buildings, anything that's part of the museum has been built with our money and largely with our labor. None of the workers get paid. We have a lot of very peculiar people. They pay money, their money, to the museum for the privilege of coming out and doing all the hard work.
I'm out here 3 days a week. I'm retired now. I think it's a challenge more than anything else, and a little nostalgia, thinking back to the way things used to be when you were a youngster. This is a car that we got from Dusseldorf, Germany. We're striving to put it back into its original condition as much as possible.
Bob Cutting is one of the volunteers who do the maintenance and restore the cars at the Trolley Museum. A former Postal Service worker, he estimates it will have taken 2 years for him and other volunteers to restore this car and add it to the collection.
Now, to longtime residents of Washington, this trolley should look familiar. It's called a PCC, and right up until 1962, you could board a car that looked like this, or maybe this very car, and travel all over Washington.
With joy,
And this is Ed Frazier, a retired school teacher who was one of the museum's most active and long-standing members.
Well, in the late 50s, we could see that line by trolley line was being closed down and buses were being substituted. So we thought if we didn't save some of these vehicles for our own pleasure, as well as people who would come out and ride them, there wouldn't be any of these cars left to show what a marvelous job they had done carrying the public.
Were they really all that great as vehicle movers, as people movers?
Yes, they were. They were fast, quiet, economical. They got you where you wanted to go, and you expected them to do it. There were drawbacks, which we realized, but hindsight, they were probably better equipped to carry people than buses.
What's your attraction for trolleys?
My attraction for trolleys goes back as far as when people used to ask me, what do you want to be, little boy, when you grow up? I actually said I wanted to drive a trolley, but I didn't get to run one until our museum opened in October 1969. I had to be taught the same as the others.
And Ed willingly passed on his skill to yet another would-be motorman.
Okay, Ed, what do I do?
First, ring a bell.
My favorite part. Now what do? That was the easy part, right?
Now take hold of the controller handle, pull it into first notch, step down on your brake pedal, and you will have power and take off.
All right, we're moving.
They may not be the smoothest starts and stops, but for me, it's not a matter of how you drive, but to where you drive. You are all my passengers, and we are taking a quick trip backwards. Next stop, 1910. Last stop, 1979. Last stop, PM Magazine Department's next.